This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Rayleigh waves are a type of surface acoustic wave that travel on solids. They can be produced in materials in many ways, such as by a localized impact or by piezoelectric transduction, and are frequently used in non-destructive testing for detecting defects. They are part of the seismic waves that are produced on the Earth by earthquakes when guided in layers. They are referred to as LAM waves, Rayleigh-LAM waves, or generalized Rayleigh waves. Contents 1 Characteristics 11 Rayleigh wave dispersion 2 Rayleigh waves in non-destructive testing 3 Rayleigh waves in electronic devices 4 Rayleigh waves in geophysics 41 Rayleigh waves from earthquakes 42 Rayleigh waves in seismology 5 Other manifestations 51 Animals 6 See also 7 Notes 8 Further reading 9 External links characteristics picture of a Rayleigh wave comparison of the Rayleigh wave speed with shear and longitudinal wave speeds for an isotropic elastic material. The speeds are shown in dimensionless units. Rayleigh waves are a type of surface wave that travel near the surface of solids. Rayleigh waves include both longitudinal and transverse motions that decrease exponentially in amplitude as distance from the surface increases. There is a phase difference between these component motions. The existence of Rayleigh waves was predicted in 1885 by Lord Rayleigh, after whom they were named in isotropic solids. These waves cause the surface particles to move in ellipses in planes normal to the surface and parallel to the direction of propagation. The major axis of the ellipse is vertical at the surface and at shallow depths. This motion is retrograde, that is, the in-plane motion of a particle is counter-clockwise. When the wave travels from left to right at greater depths, the particle motion becomes prograde. In addition, the motion amplitude decays and the eccentricity changes as the depth into the material increases. The depth of significant displacement in the solid is approximately equal to the acoustic wavelength. Rayleigh waves are distinct from other types of surface or guided acoustic waves such as Love waves or LAM waves. Both being types of guided waves supported by a layer, or longitudinal and shear waves, that travel in the bulk. Rayleigh waves have a speed slightly less than shear waves by a factor dependent on the elastic constants of the material. The typical speed of Rayleigh waves in metals is of the order of 2 to 5. CR, CS equals 0862-114. Since Rayleigh waves are confined near the surface, their in-plane amplitude when generated by a point source decays only as 1r. Where r is the radial distance, surface waves therefore decay more slowly with distance than do bulk waves, which spread out in three dimensions from a point source in seismology. Rayleigh waves called ground roll are the most important type of surface wave, and can be produced apart from earthquakes, for example, by ocean waves, by explosions, by railway trains and ground vehicles, or by a sledgehammer impact. Rayleigh wave dispersion. Dispersion of Rayleigh waves in a thin gold film on glass. The elastic constants often change with depth, due to the changing properties of the material. This means that the velocity of a Rayleigh wave becomes dependent on the wavelength and therefore frequency. A phenomenon referred to as dispersion. Waves affected by dispersion have a different wave train shape. Rayleigh waves on ideal, homogeneous and flat elastic solids show no dispersion. However, if a solid or structure has a density or sound velocity that varies with depth, Rayleigh waves become dispersive. One example is Rayleigh waves on the Earth's surface. Those waves with a higher frequency travel more slowly than those with a lower frequency. This occurs because a Rayleigh wave of lower frequency has a relatively long wavelength. The displacement of long wavelength waves penetrates more deeply into the Earth than short wavelength waves, since the speed of waves in the Earth increases with increasing depth. The longer wavelength low frequency waves can travel faster than the shorter wavelength high frequency waves. Rayleigh waves thus often appear spread out on seismograms recorded at distant earthquake recording stations. It is also possible to observe Rayleigh wave dispersion in thin films or multi-layered structures. Rayleigh waves in non-destructive testing. Rayleigh waves are widely used for materials characterization, to discover the mechanical and structural properties of the object being tested, like the presence of cracking, and the related shear modulus. This is in common with other types of surface waves. The Rayleigh waves used for this purpose are in the ultrasonic frequency range. They are used at different length scales because they are easily generated and detected on the free surface of solid objects. Since they are confined in the vicinity of the free surface within a depth tilde the wavelength linked to the frequency of the wave, different frequencies can be used for characterization at different length scales. Rayleigh waves in electronic devices. Rayleigh waves propagating at high ultrasonic frequencies 10 minus 1000. Rayleigh waves in geophysics. Rayleigh waves from earthquakes. Because Rayleigh waves are surface waves, the amplitude of such waves generated by an earthquake generally decreases exponentially with the depth of the hypocenter focus. However, large earthquakes may generate Rayleigh waves that travel around the Earth several times before dissipating in seismology. Longitudinal and shear waves are known as P waves and S waves, respectively, and are termed body waves. Rayleigh waves are generated by the interaction of P and S waves at the surface of the Earth, and travel with a velocity that is lower than the P, S, and Love wave velocities. Rayleigh waves emanating outward from the epicenter of an earthquake travel along the surface of the Earth at about 10 times the speed of sound in air 0340. The size of the earthquake, the distance to the earthquake, the depth of the earthquake, the geologic structure of the crust, the focal mechanism of the earthquake, the rupture directivity of the earthquake, local geologic structure can serve to focus or defocus Rayleigh waves, leading to significant differences in shaking over short distances. Rayleigh waves in seismology. Low-frequency Rayleigh waves generated during earthquakes are used in seismology to characterize the Earth's interior in intermediate ranges. Rayleigh waves are used in geophysics and geotechnical engineering for the characterization of oil deposits. These applications are based on the geometric dispersion of Rayleigh waves and on the solution of an inverse problem on the basis of seismic data collected on the ground surface using active sources, falling weights, hammers or small explosions, for example, or by recording microtremors. Rayleigh ground waves are important also for environmental noise and vibration control, since they make a major contribution to traffic-induced ground vibrations and the associated structure-borne noise in buildings. Other manifestations: animals, low frequency S wave, P wave, Love wave, linear elasticity. Phonon notes: Carrot, A, B, C, D. Telford, William Murray, Geldart, L. P., Robert E. Sheriff, 1990. Applied Geophysics, Cambridge University Press, p. ISBN. Lai, C.G., Wilmansky, K.E.D.'s 2005. Surface Waves in Geomechanics, Direct and Inverse Modeling for Soils and Rocks Series, CISM International Center for Mechanical Sciences, No. 481, Springer, Wien, ISBN 978-3-211-27740-9. Y. Sugawara, O. B. Wright, O. Matsuda, M. Takagihira, Y. Tanaka, S. Tamura and V. E. Gusev, Watching Ripples on Crystals, Phys. Rev. Let 88. 1855042002. External links: real-time imaging of Rayleigh waves.